see. And by a show of hands, who here is committed to creating some really extraordinary results for themselves and their lives? All right, great. And who would maybe like some tools or perspectives or to create an opening or a new possibility for themselves in terms of these extraordinary results they want to create? Anybody?
Yeah,
pass me little tools.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, you're in the right place. This is the gratitude trainings. This is the intro to the training tonight. What we're going to do tonight is talk a little bit about the training, give you some examples, and talk about what we do in the training, the type of openings you can expect to get from a training like this, and what you can expect to open up for yourself. You're taking an outrageous training like this and creating new possibilities in your life. So I want to start by introducing myself. My name is Shane Kaur, and I'm a trainer in training with gratitude, training up to facilitate the Part 1 trainings, which some of you will probably sign up for tonight. Many of you have already done, and Part 1 is a 4-day training. I'm also training up to facilitate the first weekend of the trainings in MLP. Masterful Living is the third part of the trainings. And I'll tell you more about that as the night goes along. But tonight is a drop in the bucket. Tonight is to give you an example or an idea of what kind of openings people create for themselves in trainings. And I want to quote what we just had up here back up for a second, if you could. The gratitude trainings are an opportunity to uncover and redesign the underlying assumptions out of which you live your life, such that you experience a profound shift in your ability to relate to yourself and others, empowering you to fully engage your heartfelt commitments with freedom and passion. So that first sentence there says, the trainings are an opportunity to uncover and redesign the underlying assumptions out of which we live our lives. So if you think about it, we could relate it to, like, who has an iPhone here? Anybody? A whole bunch of us? So what happens to your phone if you leave the apps running in the background and you never close them out? Run slow, drains the batteries. So, what we assert in the trainings is that human beings have apps running in the background in a way. You can say that. We have conversations and beliefs or perspectives or the way we see things in life, the way we do things or habits, things we've developed over time, that without us even realizing it, can often get in the way of our real commitments or what's really important to us in our hearts. And we all have them. I'll give you an example. I grew up in the Midwest, actually, in Kansas. Anybody ever been to Kansas? There's not a lot going on. But that's where I grew up, and you know, I grew up with a country family. And my grandpa had a conversation, or we can talk about like the underlying assumptions and beliefs that people live out of. My grandpa had one called Life is Hard. And that was something I heard a lot growing up. I remember being just a little kid, my grandpa would tell me that life is hard, son, and you better enjoy being a kid while you can, because when you grow up, it's hard out there and life's going to be hard. Now, can you see, like, if just being a little kid and growing up in a household where that was the conversation, or we could say, like, the belief system that that household lived out of, if I grew up in that household from the time I was a child, do you think I might have some beliefs or perceptions about the way life is that could get in the way of, say, if I wanted to be a millionaire? Think that could get in the way?
Yes.
So that's one example. And this is showing up for us in probably a million different possible ways. We have these underlying beliefs and assumptions we have around relationships. We have them around money, we have them around what we believe is possible or not possible in life. We have them around, you know, how many of you have ever said, I'm going to go to this dream vacation you've always wanted to take. And one day, I'm just going to go to this place, and it's going to be incredible. I'm going to get the best hotel, and or in a resort on the beach, and I'm just going to have the most incredible time of my life. And we've been talking about taking this vacation forever. maybe never got around to it? Anybody? Life got in the way a little bit. This came up, that came up, never got around to it. Or maybe one day, just after after I get this next business deal, or after I get this next job, or after when I find the right person, then I'll be happy. Anybody relate to these experiences? I know I do. And these are what we're talking about, like an underlying assumption that we might be living under. Like we're waiting for something to happen in life, and it just hasn't quite happened yet. And once things work out, then I'll have the life I want. And, you know, in reference to this article, or this paragraph I just read up here, the underlying beliefs and assumptions, we can say, are what stop us from taking action toward those things that really matter to us in life. So I can say that, I went through a breakup in high school. And maybe going into another relationship 10 years later, I might think that'll happen again. So I just avoid getting into a relationship. Or I withhold myself in relationships. I don't give it my 100%. I don't give it everything I have. So these are a few examples. I don't want to get too deep right off the bat, just kind of diving in with you. But I want to give you an example of what the training is. Because until we illuminate these beliefs and these perspectives, these conversations for ourselves, they'll just run under the surface, just like the apps on the iPhone. So if I was going to say one thing about the trainings, just to open up with, it's an opportunity to really see what it is that gets in the way for us. What gets in the way of our passion, our joy, our excitement, our happiness, our freedom. What gets in the way of living the kind of life that we always dreamed we would, or always hoped we would, or always imagined we would, just never quite got around to. And the training is a way to really open that up for yourself so you can go after your heartfelt commitments with freedom and passion and really open that up for yourself. So if there was a training that could open all that up for you, probably worth looking at, yes? So that's what this is. So welcome to the Introduction to Gratitude. Woo! Like I said, my name is Shane Fuller. I'm a trainer in training for gratitude, and I'll be facilitating pieces of the training next year. I'm also a life coach. I coach primarily on relationships, but I also coach people sometimes in their businesses and other things they have going on. But focus a lot on relationships. I do some work in recovery centers. I do transformational groups. I do some of the work we do in the trainings, some other things too, but I go into treatment centers and work with clients in treatment about getting on with their lives in a way that they're inspired and passionate about what's important to them, and having them get their lives matter. So this is the line of work I'm in. This is what I do. And I did my trainings in 2014, a few years ago, and completely changed my life. It was like I was headed in one direction, and then I did the trainings, and it's like now I'm headed in this direction, and it's better than I ever could imagine. And I'll tell you my story as the night goes on also. So that's what the training is, and that's the possibility that we're here to invite everybody into. Being said, I want to start by taking a little bit of sharing from the guests. So if you're the guests, don't be shy, it's okay. I know these people might seem a little strange, but they're all wonderful people. So thank you, guests. Let's give the guests a round.
Yeah! Welcome, welcome.
So I know it's a Monday night, and there's a lot of things that all of you can be doing, especially the guests. And some of you are probably here because you have a friend or a family member who's telling you about it. And they may seem a little weird, like they weren't quite themselves, but they seem really excited and inspired by something, and you're like, well, maybe I should check this out, because whatever they did is pretty cool. Anybody have that experience? And maybe some of you were thrown in the trunk of the car and dragged here by your hair, and you're like, I have no idea why I'm here. Is that anybody? Well, whatever the reason that you're here, you know, I want to say thank you for being here. You know, you could be anywhere else on a Monday night. And you chose to be here with me, with us as a community, with your friend and your family members who invited you. That says a lot about who you are, that you take a risk and trust and come here. So thank you so much. Let's give one more round of applause. And I'd like to get to know the guests a little bit. We don't have too many in here, so we might get a chance for everybody to share. But if you brought a guest, in a minute I'll just raise your hand, I'll call on you. And I want you to stand up and just tell us what's great about your friend or your guest that you brought. So, not like, this is my friend Bobby, and man, his life is so messed up, he really needs this training. Not like that. I'll actually say nobody needs this. Not a single person who's done it or ever will do it needs it. This training is actually not about fixing broken lives. This training is about people who are up to something extraordinary and they're really looking to open up a new possibility out of that commitment so they can take it to a level they didn't even imagine possible. That's what the training is for. So I assume the guests and everybody who came tonight, you're already perfect, whole, and complete, and you don't need the training at all. But I would like to hear what's great about your guest, because I'm sure there's some pretty amazing people here tonight. And I'd like to hear from the guests, what is an area of your life? If there was something you really wanted to take to an extraordinary level of your life, what would that be? Just an area of your life, business, relationships, community. So who would like to introduce their guest?
I'm Carly. I don't need it, right?
No.
Okay. So, I'm going to act like I'm using it. I'm Marley. I'm ML43. And my guest is Brittany, right here. I've known her since high school. We went to high school together. She played basketball with somebody that I was dating, so we ended up getting close at that point. And she's always been the one to make me laugh. She's always like the life of the party. She's like a class clown, but in a great way. She loves people, and you can tell just by talking to her. And I think just after what I've gone through, that this could work wonders for her, and I can see her reach heights that I don't even see for myself, you know. So I will give it to Brittany now.
Do you mind if I ask you, Brittany? You say you're making errors in your life. What's something that matters to you that you see these errors getting in your life?
Music.
Music? So what would you like to do with music? And what would that look like for you at the highest level possible? All right. So whatever's getting in the way of you building that empire for yourself, that record-producing empire, you want to just break through all of that so you can really take it to the next level. All right? Wonderful. Thank you. And when people share throughout the night, we're going to applaud. And the reason we applaud is because we acknowledge that people are taking a risk when they stand up and speak. They did studies, and they found that the number one fear of a human being is public speaking. That's even above death. So there's an old Seinfeld joke. He says that means if you were at a funeral, you'd rather be the one in the casket than the one doing the eulogy. So we acknowledge the risk that people take, and that's why we'll applaud when we share. Who else would like to introduce? Yes.
I'm Marsha, ML43.
I've known Mark for about 10 years, and Mark is brilliant. Mark is inquisitive and curious and seeking. I would say visionary and motivated.
All right. Thank you. The aspirations that I have is doing something for myself, doing something in a technical way, with my standards. So you mean business-wise, you'd like to really create something that's your product?
Absolutely.
Right?
I'm not sure what's holding me back. I don't know, you know what I mean, what switches that I need to unlock, you know, to move forward, to pass that with fear of that uncomfortable.
Well, I'm actually glad you bring that up because a lot of what the training is about is recognizing what it is that holds you back. We really don't know until we know. But if there was something in your way and it was like a blind spot, like you couldn't see it, then you wouldn't know until you took some course of action that opened that up. Does that make sense? Anything else, Mark? Oh yeah, thank you for asking. ML, and a couple of people might say it tonight, the third part of the program, the gratitude training program, is a 3-month coaching program, essentially. It's where you, after you do the first couple parts of the training, you go out into the world and you work with a team and a coach, and you actually go about creating extraordinary results in your life. So when people say ML, I'm ML 18 or ML 43, those are the numbers. Each team has a number as we go along. Yeah, so the first one was ML1, and then now she's ML4.
Oh, yeah.
She stands for Masterful Living. Yes. Do you want to introduce yourself?
Sure.
You mind?
Stefano Irizarry, this is my lovely fiancée, Geraldine Pasquale. And I'm a graduate of Landmark Education. I was a coach for self-professional leadership for years, over 10 years. And I have a magical life right now. And that's absolutely wonderful. We got engaged on our second boat cruise, and just we have magic every day of our lives. But I'm looking for something. In fact, about 4 days ago, 5 days ago, I got my hair cut at her place, and we're standing there, and there was somebody who was in my course, advanced course, and she said, have you heard of the graduate, this course right here? I said, no, I never did. Tell me about it. So she goes, well, it's really from the heart, and when people grow, they love it. And I said, great. And that was 5 days ago. Mm-hmm. So I'm here today, and I'm really excited about this course. Hopefully that's it.
Extraordinary life, and that's awesome. But what do you see being next for you? Like, if you were to take it even deeper,
I think for me, the next stage would be more of just like building the businesses that I'm involved with right now, life insurance and getting to payroll and disability and other stuff. So I think building my businesses, and also solar energy, possibly when I spoke to someone tonight, James.
Well, that's
and that was a very interesting match. Like, I'm looking into starting a solar energy business. And boom, right there's James. Is he here right now?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
So I've done some of my bucket lists and been to Africa and I'd love to travel, but I'd love to feel better about, you know, not going to have all this nervous breakdowns and just, you know, put a deposit in a huge trip.
Absolutely. So you can see where that fear stops you from really going for it.
Yeah.
You
could. Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you.
She's loving, she is responsible and reliable, and she takes matters into her own hands, and she's the biggest example of that.
So is there an area of your life that, you know, there was something, and you said you retired, so now what for you? There's something
now
that was
I'm
next.
A property manager.
Property manager?
Yeah.
Is there...
Yeah, in the area.
So you want to really be super successful with that, or... Yeah? All right, so if you're going to use a training like this to support you, your life, would that be an area
I'm not sure. I don't know.
You're not sure if you would want to take that area of your life to the next level, or you're not sure if you want to do training? Well, you don't need it. But you see an area of your life that you can start doing. And when the time is showing that you need the training, then you can make it. Okay, but if you were to do it at some point, you can see an area you would apply it to would be your property management company. All right. Thank you. Okay, so here's what I want to do with the guests who haven't had a chance to share yet. I just want you to turn to somebody you don't know and just same question we're asking. What is an area of your life, if you were to do a training like this, what is an area of your life that you would want to apply to? Just take maybe, let's say, 5 minutes and get to know somebody you don't already know and share with them what's the area of your life that you'd like to apply training like this to. And then 5 minutes starts now.
Thank you. Thank you.
your spirituality. The trainings aren't about any of that, necessarily. The trainings are about how you are in your life in relationship to all of that. And a common slogan we use in the trainings is, the way you do anything is the way you do everything. So like what Miller was speaking into, she came in to have breakthroughs in business, in her career. And as she was going about creating those breakthroughs for herself, she started to notice being different with her family in a relationship, and opening up possibilities in other areas. So the training focuses on you, or me as a person, and what gets in our way in relationship to certain things. But you'll notice when you do the training, when you have breakthroughs in one area, it starts to spill over.
Relationship, and there are times in my relationship where I think, like, well, this is as good as it gets, and then next thing I know, like, we're planning on moving in together, and then the next thing I know, like, we're planning on getting married, and like, all this awesome stuff. So, definitely relationships and love so much. And then another place I just like to talk about, you said one, but like, so one other place is like is courage and self-confidence, which is like, again, I didn't even know how much courage I would get to add into my life, and like knowing what it is that I'm worth, and like going for things that like I would think, well, I'm not qualified to do this, or I don't have the experience to do this, or like I can't do this because whatever it is. And like before I did the trainings, I really wanted to go back to school, and I didn't, because like I didn't have the money, I didn't qualify for grants because of the way that I went to school beforehand. And just recently, like I graduated from Palm Beach State, and I took my GPA from Magna Cum Laude, and I took my GPA from a 2.6 to a 3.79, and on like, yeah, I can do this, and I'm gonna do it no matter what.
Woo! Yeah.
This guy's a real rule breaker. He went to one of the three top ones, he's going to two of the bottom ones. you want to speak into personal
That's
power?
Exactly what I'm
all saying. Right, go on.
Yeah! Woo!
Hey, Nikki. Especially because Brian stole my category. It's funny, I've spoken courage and self-confidence before, so I was feeling that personal power and freedom. Hi, I'm Nikki.
Hi, Nikki.
I'm ML, Masterful Living 32. And I have definitely had breakthroughs in all of these categories in different ways, like Shane's speaking into, you know, organically. Our growth unfolds in all domains, all doing being in the work and participating in the trainings and being supported by this amazing community. What really opened up for me is that it ties into vision. Like, first of all, be empowered to realize that I have a gift, I have a contribution to make to the world. And when I was, before I did the training, my smallness, or my conversation, having the idea that, like, you know, oh, I can't handle that, or, you know, I don't have what it takes. And these were all, like, really unconscious, you know, that I don't matter on some level. Like, I just basically, like, you just got to work hard. Life is hard, and then you die, you know, like, you just have to work hard and to get by. There was a lot of conversations in my family that life is a struggle. And realizing that, like, it doesn't need to be a struggle. I have something to give back. I have a vision about, you know, to create the world that I want to see. And I am empowered now to make that happen. And through that, I experience a tremendous amount of freedom because I stand from a place that I can create what I say I want. And I'm not limited or held back by my past or my circumstances or, you know, my family experiences, my childhood. Like, that's in the past, and that's where it is today. And it's all beautiful. It's all been perfect. It all got me to this place right here and right now. So thank you for allowing me to share with you.
Your boy, Denoy. Denoy! It's your boy.
And going through the trainings, it really opened up a space where, like, I get to do these things. Like, I get to have an awesome relationship with my son. I get to go to work and be an inspiration to people in my life. I get to do all the things on my list and have them happen and create my life in such a powerful way that I'm the creator of my life. And having a team to stand behind me and stand behind my word and hold me high, you know, and really show me my reflection and how I'm showing up in that relationship to my commitment and responsibility has been a great impact.
Yeah! The man is so cool.
Whatever, that's the case with a lot of people. What also happens with a lot of people is they do the trainings and all of a sudden they realize they were already in the relationship of their dreams. Or they already had the life of their dreams and they just weren't seeing it. And so it's not necessarily about the details of life, but it's about our perception and how we experience. It's like wearing a pair of glasses. And you look out at the world through these glasses, and then these glasses color your experience with the world. And the training, in a lot of ways, is like putting on a new pair of glasses and seeing life in a different way. That's when the possibilities begin to show up where we didn't see them before. All of a sudden, life seems like a free, joyful, happy, inspiring place, as opposed to this heavy, life is hard, kind of
burdenous
place that a lot of people live out. So thank you
for bringing
that up,
Jamal.
Mark,
you want
to go off? Yeah! Yes! Well, I'm going to ask you to speak into abundance or courage.
Mark, for those of you that don't know me, Mark, for those of you that do know me, Mark. No, actually, I've noticed a couple of things in my life. I've noticed that a lot of times when we go through life, we become comfortable in the space that we are, and we take things for granted, and regardless of what it is that we have, we want
to be... Did this happen for you, Mark?
For me.
Okay.
For me. I not only didn't reflect on the things that I was doing in my life that was abundantly rich, but
this going, that going, this going. I was able to check off all these things that I was grateful for. And the things that I wasn't doing in my life, I was able to step into the power to say, look, I can do this, I can do that, and I can be even responsible for everything. And I don't look around me and try to blame someone else for what's going on. I don't think about what's happening right now, because I know whatever it is that I'm doing, I still have the power to change it. And wherever I am, no matter what I'm doing, I am responsible for everything. And with that, it allows me to see all the abundance of people, the love, the caring, the people that come in and out of my life. You know, just being able to create finances, being able to create the life of your dream, just being able to see the things that you have already and appreciate them. With that, I'm grateful.
Went that route the rest of my life. So I was in this job, and it got mundane, I would say, for me, right? And I was kind of bored with it, and I saw like a bigger vision for myself. And so when I was in Masterful Living, I decided to quit my job and take a risk. And that's weird, right? Because you're told your whole life, don't quit your job unless you have something else lined up. So my parents went, you're insane. What are you doing? And I'm like, I got this, right? And I took a risk. And it enabled me to have the confidence and the tools that I learned in Masterful Living and the personal freedom and power and courage that I accessed through part one and part two to take that. And I had this team of people in Masterful Living that said, yes, you can do anything. And so I went and got this little receptionist job for the time being, and it paid my bills, and it was amazing. And then I stepped into volunteering in the community, the gratitude community, and Joe Engelson, the founder of the company, after 2 years of volunteering my time, said, hey, I want to pay you for what you do. Do you want to come work for me? Because of who I was being and the way that I showed up in service and in volunteering, and with that, if I wouldn't have stepped into the courage that, yes, I can do this and step out of my comfort zone, I've been the training manager for the company for about 4 years now, and it gets better and better each day. But if I didn't have the courage from my team of Masterful Living for the breakthroughs that I had in part two and these aha moments in part one, I would not have taken that risk, and I promise you, I was also in a relationship that was no bueno for me. And I got the courage to leave that relationship, start a new career. I lost about 100 pounds during my last Masterful Living. I recently lost 65 more pounds from there, and so taking my health on. And it wouldn't have happened if I didn't do these trainings. And if I didn't have a community and a team behind me, there's no way I would be living the life that I lead today.
I say we can all go home.
Chris has dropped it.
We've already covered that. Do you want to say something quickly?
I do.
Okay.
Jill.
There you are. Oh.
But Jill.
Published a book that I've been waiting to publish for 30 years, and my life has changed. Thank you.
Thank you. mentioned, she works probably harder than anybody I've ever met in my life. So let's give her one more. Creating an unprecedented future. It's something that wouldn't have happened anyway. Like I have no doubt that every single one of us has the potential to be wildly successful with or without these trainings. But the trainings, like Chris was saying, without having the courage to take a risk and go after something that she never would have gone after, like Jill was saying, you know, published a book that she otherwise wouldn't have published. The training is about opening something up in your life that would not have otherwise happened. It's about seeing something in a way that you would not have otherwise seen it, that then opens up a brand new possibility that otherwise she's never would have been. It's like this. Let's say that this circle represents all the knowledge in the universe. Okay, so anything that anybody ever has known, or ever will know, or knows right now, all the possible known knowledge in any domain in the entire universe, that's what this circle represents. How much do you think you know? A little bit? Less than that?
1 × 10⁻¹⁰.
So maybe like a dot, right? And that's probably a lot, actually. We'll say this dot represents, and just so we can see it, I'll draw like a slice of a pie. So this dot represents what I know. But it's not only what I know. I know it. What else? I know that I know. So I know that I know. What's an example of something that you know and you know that you know?
Organic chemistry.
Organic chemistry. So Durbin's, you know organic chemistry, and you know that you know organic chemistry. So if I need somebody to do, I'm not even sure what that is, but if I need somebody to do organic chemistry for me, I can come to you and you can handle it.
Yep.
All right.
You're a college student, yeah.
Awesome. What's something else that you know and you know that you know? You know how to drive a car. So you know how to drive a car and you know that you know how to drive a car. So you can just pretty much get in the car anytime, anywhere, and drive it in the car. All right. Now, if this is I know that I know, what do you think this is?
I know that I don't know.
I don't know that I know.
You don't know what you know? I know that I don't know?
I know that I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know. I know I don't know.
So let's say I don't know. I don't know, and I know that I don't know. Okay, so I don't know it, but I know that I don't know it. Like, for example, I don't know organic chemistry, and I know that I don't know organic chemistry. I do know how to drive a car, and I know that I know how to drive a car, but I don't know how to drive or fly a plane. But I do know that I don't know how to fly a plane. Now, here's the thing about the things that I don't know, I miswrote that. It's I know that I don't know. So here's the thing about the things I know that I don't know, is if I wanted to learn how to do organic chemistry, I would take a class on it, or read a book, or study it, or, you know, I know it's out there, and I know the means by which I can get to it. Does that make sense? It's like if I wanted to fly a plane, I don't know right now how to fly a plane, But if I wanted to learn, I would just go take a class or read some books or study. But I know that it's available to me. And if I wanted to learn about it, I would just go follow the proper procedures to learn that. So these two things really are within the realm of what I know. Do you see that? Whether you know it or you know that you don't know it, it's all in a way within the realm of the things you know. What do you think the rest of this circle is?
I don't know that I don't know.
So I don't know it, but I don't even know that I don't know it. It's like completely off my radar. Even if I wanted to find out about it, I wouldn't even know what it was I wanted to find out about. This is where the training operates. It's like that unprecedented future that we're talking about. That's within the realm of, I don't even know what I don't know about that. Or like we're talking about with Mark. We were saying this at the beginning, was there's something in the way of really going after the life of my dreams with no regrets, nothing stopping me. There's something there, but I don't even know what it is. And if I wanted to have a breakthrough in it, I wouldn't even know where to begin because it's completely off my radar. I don't even know that I don't know that. Do you see how those underlying things that could be stopping us in life, until we illuminate them, there's no way to get at it. So we can say that what's getting in our way, until we illuminate it, until we bring it within the realm of the things we know, it's just going to keep getting in our way. Just like an app running underneath the surface of the phone. Until we bring it up on the screen and turn it off, it's just going to keep running, keep draining the energy. This is the same thing. Let's take another example. Do you have that slide ready for me, Patrick? Can you turn my mic down just a little bit? Oh, I'm sorry. Cover that. I forgot. Before we go into this, I want everybody's agreement, no talking. So can everybody agree to this process, no talking? Let's just do this. If you do not agree to not talk during this process, then. All right, great. So I have everybody's agreement. As soon as we begin this process, no talking. Now, in a minute, I'm going to put something on the screen, and it's going to be something you've either seen before, you've said before, you read before. So it's something from your past. We're going to put it on the screen. I just want everybody to take a minute to look at it, to read it, and then we'll take it off the screen. Okay? So we'll do that. Right, thank you. Pull it up. Who read Bird in the Hand, Paris in the Spring, once in a lifetime? Okay. Does not say that. No talking. But just notice, even as I say that, what comes up for you, like, I know what I saw. That Shane guy, I don't know if I trust him. He's telling me I didn't read what I read. Or just notice, because something, even what comes up for you right now, is just you being you in this moment. And just notice what comes up for you, but I promise it doesn't say that. Now, in a moment, I'll put it up again. And continue to be honest throughout this process. But I just want to see if you still read the same thing. So let's go ahead, put that back up. So if you still read Bird in the Hand, Paris in the Spring, once in a lifetime, raise your hand. Be honest, it's okay. Look around. You're not the only one. But it does not say that. Notice a few people didn't raise their hands this time. So maybe some of you got it, or maybe some of you just, I'm not raising my hand. I don't know what's going on. So even if, just notice, like even that, and I promise it does not say that. Good do it one more time. We'll put it up here. And I just want to see if you're still reading the same thing. So go ahead. Pull it up. Thank you. If you still read Bird in the Hand, Paris in the Spring, once in a lifetime version. Some people are just like, I'm not even playing. And some of you might have seen it, and what are you noticing about the people who didn't see it? These people just can't get it? Just notice that, because that's just you doing you also. But whatever's going on for you right now, one thing I know for sure, it does not say that. Now, I'd like a guest to be willing to take a risk and come up here and work with me. Yes, you saw it. So somebody who didn't see it. Not somebody who didn't see it. Want to come up and take a risk? Let's get going.
Yeah, Mark!
It doesn't say that, but we'll see what it says in a minute. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this back up, and I just want you to look at it again and just see if you're still going to see it. Okay? Thank you. Still read Bird in the Hand, Paris in the Spring, Once in a Lifetime?
Absolutely.
Okay. But now, let's be honest with him, because he's taking a risk right now. Who else reads Bird in the Hand, Paris in the Spring, Once in a Lifetime? So it's not just you. So it's a bunch of us in here. But it does not say that. Now, I'm going to do it one more time. What I want you to do is point to every single word and read them out loud. Okay?
I guess it doesn't say it, but it reads it. Bird in the Hand. Paris in the Spring. Oh, wow.
So this is what human beings do, actually. We all do it. Walking into a situation as though we've already been in this situation before and looking at it like, I already know what this is, without even like a, you know, an automatic, Janoi said, or not noticing the details of the situation. But walking into life, like every moment, like, I already know what this moment has to offer me. Can you see how we might miss possibilities? Yeah, seeing what we expect to see. Like we were talking about earlier, like, life is hard. If I'm walking into situations like, life is hard, do you think I might miss how easy it could actually be? Or if I'm in a relationship and the other person is doing something that maybe somebody from my past did, or I perceive them doing something like somebody from my past did, instead of being with this person in this moment in a new possibility, I'm reacting as though it were the past happening all over again. Or with money, some people shared earlier about money, like having conversations where it was you know, the fear around money, like I know how money works, or I know how I am with money, or how money works for me in my life. And do you think, Joanne, like you're saying, you miss out on stuff because you're not really going for it? And I hope you don't mind me using you here. But we miss out on things in life because we're living from the way we believe it is from the past, or from the way we made up it is, from our interpretations and beliefs. Remember, the underlying assumptions that we live out that determine the way we experience life. So let's give everybody a round of applause. In a minute, we'll take a little stop for a second and have an opportunity to sign up, and then we'll come back, and the part two people will then have a chance to do their demonstration. But before we go into all of that, I want to say a couple things about the training, and then I want to tell you a little bit about myself also, and you know, just what's opened up for me through the trainings. The training works on something we call accelerated learning technology. And some of you may have heard of it, maybe not, but has anybody in here ever heard of a super can? A super can. Do you know what a super camp is?
A super camp is one of those camps where super camp is one of those camps designed where you just get force-fed all sorts of knowledge, and the way they do it, it sticks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, Chris. Yes, a super camp is actually essentially what you said. But these super camps that they have now, they're actually using the same kind of technology we use in the training. There's a lot of elements to it, but ultimately, these camps are having fifth grade children graduate high school with their GED. So this is the type of technology you said that the information is presented in a way where it sticks. And there's several elements that go into it, but one of the major elements that we use in the training is what I call experiential learning. So how many of you remember, let's say, something you learned in high school? Not you, Gervins. But how many of you remember something, say you say advanced algebra? Couple of you, a little bit. And for those of you who remember advanced algebra, how many of you remember biology? Couple of you. How many of you remember literature? All right. Well, how would you gauge the experience of, say, learning advanced algebra in high school to what you learned through your first kiss? Two very different types of learning, yes? Mm-hmm. Or let's say learning algebra or biology in high school to learning how to drive a car. Very different types of learning, right? What do you think is more available to you in this moment? How to kiss, how to drive a car, for advanced algebra.
The car.
This is experiential learning. What we just did here with the bird and the hand exercise, that was actually an experience. Like you actually had an experience of maybe missing something. Or even if you saw it, you got to experience your reaction to the material that was being presented here. Like I said, tonight's a drop in the bucket. It's not really like on a scale of 1 to 10, if the training, the part one training was a 10, tonight's like a 0.2. So it's a drop in the bucket, but experiential learning through actually experiencing something, you integrate the learning in a way where it becomes a part of who you are. It becomes a part of, like, it's available to you. Like, it's unforgettable. You can't unlearn it once you have an experience around something. So the training we're designed, or the way we designed the training, it's intended to give you experiences where you actually confront those things that get in your way or stop you from really going after what you want in your life. And you actually get to have the experience of breaking through that. So you do it within the safety of the training room, at least in part one and part two. But it's a real experience where you actually know what it's like to confront and break through everything that's stopping you. Like some people, how many of you know that being comfortable can really get in your way of creating extraordinary results? So there may be times in the training where you would confront your discomfort in a way that, well, you do it in a training room. When you take it out into your life, you know, I've confronted this before. I know who I get to be right now. I know what I get to do. And then you can go for it in your life. And we actually have a 3-month coaching program we got Masterful Living that's designed to have you practicing that in your life. So that's most of what I have to say about the trainings. Now, I want to give you the breakdown of how the curriculum works. You've heard me speak into all three parts of the training throughout the night. Part one is a 4-day course. It's a Thursday night, a Friday night, all day Saturday, all day Sunday. So Thursday and Friday night, you'll be there from 6 p.m. to midnight. All day Saturday, it's about a 12-hour day. Sunday will be from 11 in the morning. 7:30 p.m. Here's a graduation ceremony. So that's the 4-day training, part one. And that training is $495 for all 4 days. Part two is 5 full days. So it's Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, all day, every day. Don't make any other plans. You're not going to be doing anything else except for the training. And for those of you who have done part two, what do you have to say about it?
Oh,
my God.
Yeah!
Yeah! Oh, yeah. It's great.
So, holy part two, like, part one, we call it the awareness the discovery training. So those things that get in your way in life that we've been talking about tonight, part one is the awareness training where you actually have that stuff revealed to you, where you get to look at that stuff. It's the discovery training. Part two, we call it breakthrough. That's like taking dynamite to every self-limiting belief that's ever gotten in your way. I say in part two, you have the opportunity to break through every self-limiting belief ever have. I don't know whether you do it or not, that'll be up to you. But the opportunity in part two is absolutely, you can take on and break through everything that's ever gotten in your way of your life. And part two is $11.95 for all 5 days. And then And then part three is the Masterful Living Program. It's a key part. We also call it ML, or Masterful Living. That's a three-month coaching program. You're working with a coach. You're working with a team. That's about after having illuminated things for yourself in part one, taking them on, breaking through them in part two. Part three, you go out and take it on in the real world, in your life, with the support of a coach, with the support of a team. It's about creating extraordinary results. There will be four in-person weekends where you'll be in a training over the course of the 3 months, and then the rest of it just happens in your life. Every day, you're practicing it in your life, you're getting coaching, you're getting support, having breakthroughs, creating new possibilities, and really going for it. That's the third part of the program, and that is $18.95 for the 3 month coaching program. Part one, and that's what you'll have the opportunity, I mean, you can sign up for all of these tonight if you want to. If you do choose to sign up for all three at the same time, we have specials and package pricing available. And there's some people at the back table that will be happy to support you with that. If you just choose to sign up for part one tonight, you will, all that's required is a $295 deposit. And that'll get your spot reserved in whatever training date you choose. We also have some specials tonight. So, you know, we like to reward guests because we know it's a lot to take your time to come out here and, you know, spend your money tonight with us. So if you sign up for part one or any of the trainings tonight, if you sign up for part one with at least a $295 deposit, we'll give you a free pass to Transacting or Team Transacting. This is it's an improv acting workshop where it's a lot of fun. People say they laugh harder than they've ever laughed in their entire lives. Who's done Transacting here?
Yeah.
How great was it?
So much fun.
That was pretty damn fun.
All right, so it's an incredible training. It's one day. It's a Saturday morning to evening. It's like 9 to 5 on a Saturday. It's one day. It's using the distinctions and perspectives of the training through improv acting in your life.
And it's 5 days from today. It's on May 20th.
Well, it's 5 days from today. Is that the only date they can use?
Yes.
Okay, so the training, Transacting training is 5 days from today. On a Saturday. It is Saturday, right?
Yep, it's Saturday. And you can choose either Teen Transacting or Adult Transacting. And they can be about 16 years old or older to attend the Adult Transacting. And they can be from like 10 years old up until like 16 for the Teen Transacting.
So you can either do it yourself or gift it to a friend or a young friend. So that's Transacting, and if you sign up tonight with at least a $295 deposit, you'll get a pass for Transacting. And also, if you brought a guest tonight, and your guest chooses to do the training, those of you who graduated part one or beyond, we'll give you a pass to the Breakthrough Training, which is facilitated by our training director, Francine Ray. Many of you know her. She's a force of nature, but she is absolutely incredible. She was my trainer when I did the trainings, and she's actually my trainer now. So, and she's absolutely incredible. She's doing a one-day workshop called Breakthrough, where it's again an opportunity to really look at and break through whatever's getting in the way of your vision, so that you can go after it, inspired and passionate. And for those of you who brought a guest tonight, and your guest enrolls, we'll offer you a pass to Breakthrough. And our gratitude for you bringing your friend out. So these are the trainings, and we'll be around. You can chat with us if you want. I'd like to take just a couple minutes before we move on and tell you my story. So I did my trainings, like I said, 2014. So it's been, 3 years now, a little over 3 years. And, you know, I wasn't, like I say, nobody needs the trainings, and I didn't need the trainings. My life was working. I had a a steady job. I had a nice house. I had great friends. I was in a relationship. I had everything taken care of for the most part. I wasn't going without anything. But, you know, we've been talking a lot tonight about the underlying assumptions and the perspectives and beliefs that we live out of that stop us. And I certainly had a lot of that, that not only had I not looked at it, but I didn't know it was there. And I had a lot of it around money. You know, if I wanted to do something, say take a vacation or invest in something or whatever it was around money, it would require me to do a lot of planning, a lot of saving, a lot of detail work and figuring everything out and getting all my ducks in a row, and I couldn't execute any new step in my life until I had it all figured out in advance and I could see how it would all play out. And that really held me back. Like, any progress I made, and I don't know where I would be today had I not done the trainings, but I know at that point in my life, like, progress was really slow for me. And I had things I wanted to go after. There were some things in life that really inspired me, but I felt like work was work, and what I enjoyed doing was what I enjoyed doing, and those were two separate things, and that I would never, I didn't see it being really possible for me to earn a living and sustain myself doing what I love and enjoy. I didn't think that was possible. I worked really hard. You know? Like I said, life is hard, right? So I worked really hard. I worked a lot of hours and made a lot less than I do now. And I just thought that was the way it was. And I did a lot of the same things as you know. Like I was coaching people. I was doing some public speaking. But I was doing it all for free because I didn't think I was valuable enough to charge for it. I didn't think I was worth charging money for that. And you know, my life was very busy. I had a lot of stuff going on. I was filling up all my time. I didn't really feel like I was kidding. And that was my experience of life. It wasn't going anywhere. I had no vision. I wasn't surviving and sustaining, and for the most part, making it look good as much as I could. But I wasn't really joyful or inspired or fulfilled or passionate about life. And I didn't have anything going on for me that created that passion. That was my life. And I was in a relationship, and my relationship then was pretty much like I just explained the rest of my life. It was good. It looked good. We got along. We had fun together. We never fought. But it wasn't passionate. It wasn't fulfilling. I kind of knew from day one that this wasn't the person I wanted to spend my life with. And, you know, I found myself a year and a half down the road in a relationship with this person just because nothing over the course of that year and a half had become so uncomfortable that I wanted to leave. It was really comfortable, just like I said, the rest of my life, pretty much going anywhere. But I wasn't inspired by it. I wasn't fulfilled. And I knew that this relationship, like my life, wasn't what I wanted. And also, I didn't feel like I really deserved more, or maybe I felt like I deserved it, but I didn't think it was available. I thought, you know, those people who live the life of their dreams, I thought those were other people out there somewhere. That they were the ones who lived the life of their dreams. And I just do this. That's kind of my experience and how I saw life and lived life. And I got to challenge a lot of these underlying assumptions and these beliefs and trainings. Really get that, you know, the life of your dreams is not for anybody else. Like, it's for me or for you. That if I wanted to matter, I wanted my life to be important, the only person who really had any say in that was me. And I got that my life wasn't happening on accident. You know, I felt like I was the victim of life. I was born into this circumstance with this family, and alcoholic father and, you know, left my mother at 13 and kind of ended up in all these situations. Like, I was just a victim of life, and I was stuck in it. And then I was just dealing with the cards I was dealt in a way. And, you know, through the trainings, I really realized that, you know, if I wanted to have an extraordinary life, the only person who had any say about it was me. And I had to care enough about my own life to step up and say, this is what I want my life for. And, you know, there's been a lot that's happened over the last few years, and a lot that continues to happen, but, you know, in a nutshell, I do what I love every day. I coach people, I do workshops, I train people, I support people living their dreams every day, and so that's what it was for me, and we all have something that, you know, is that thing for us, and whatever it is for you, my deepest, sincerest wish. I do what I love every day. I'm in an incredible relationship with an absolutely extraordinary woman. She's sitting right there. And you know, my life is really beyond whatever I had imagined was possible when I walked through the doors of Part One. And it continues to be more extraordinary. The things I'm doing this year, I never imagined I would be doing last year, and I'm pretty clear that the things I'm doing next year are beyond what I imagine doing now. I keep practicing the distinctions, and the principles, and the perspectives of the training in my life, and my life continues to unfold in an increasingly exciting and powerful way. And that's my wish for absolutely everything. If you have the courage to stand up and say you deserve that, you can have that too. There's nobody in here that is exempt from that. And I know we all have stuff. You know, I know the trainings a lot of times can seem expensive. I'll just say, you know, who having done these trainings would have spent $20,000 on? The value that's created. You know, I think it's in New Zealand, they do these same exact trainings for corporate CEOs, like Levi Strauss and Tommy Bahama and some of these guys. They do the same Part One training that we charge $495 for. They charge, I believe it's $6,000 for the same exact training. So Joe Engelson's vision around this is to really make accessible and affordable to everyone. And I know it can seem like a lot of money. When I did the trainings, I had no money. At least none to spare. And I know we have work circumstances, and, you know, 4 days, 5 days can seem like a lot of time. That's what I want to say. Like, when it comes time to sign up for the training, like, I'll say that your training begins the moment you choose to do. And when it comes time to sign up for the training, all the circumstances or considerations, you say, oh, I just got to figure out the time, or I got to figure out the money. Usually, the people who have the money don't have the time, and the people who have the time don't have the money. But they're both two sides of the same coin. You know, you can have all the money in the world, but if you don't have the freedom to live your life the way you want to, what is it worth? Or you can have all the time in the world, but if you don't have the money and the resources to experience what you want to experience in life, then the time can't be used to its maximum potential. So, you know, they're two sides of the same coin. But I'll say that whatever is stopping you in life, like the big things that stop you in life, is probably what's going to come up for you the moment you want to do the training. And this is my invitation for everybody here, is don't wait. Like, sign up now. And if you need to figure out your circumstances to get the time off, then, you know, make a commitment to be there. And then out of that commitment, be however you need to be to arrange the time. If you don't have the money, like, great. You know, sign up and set up a payment plan go out in your life and live into that commitment such that you generate money you wouldn't have had anyway. Now, we don't want anybody's rent money here. We're not about that. We're about people having the resources in their lives to live the lives they want to have. And whatever it takes you to get in the door of part one, just to start, that's the training happening right there in your life. The value is here. And we also have a money-back guarantee, so if you do part one and part two, and it doesn't, you don't create the value for yourself that you had intended to when you do the training, just write a letter within 24 hours. We'll refund all the money for part one and two, no questions asked. And that's how much we need in these trainings. So in a minute, we'll give you an opportunity to enroll, but don't leave. We want you to stay because the people who just graduated part two have a presentation they want to share with you. So we'll take about, it's 9 o'clock now. Let's say we'll take 15 minutes to, you guys can register and sign up. There's people at the back table to support you. And then let's start back up at 9:15. And we'll have the part two graduates come up and share their gift. All right?
Okay, we're going through this.
Thank you.